Okay. So this is probably going to be the shortest segment in this series. Because this is the shortest segment in the game. So we want to get our lamp of time charge. Now, the time that I use it is when I fall past this little rock outcropping right here. That's my cue. So, okay, that's just cute. I'm gonna reset the room so this guy isn't dumping on me. So we use it here. The reason why we want to make sure that we use it... Wow, did I really do that? I guess I did. The reason why I want to use it there is because I need to interact with the dais in that room, and I don't want the lamp of time to be active, because you can interact with this thing while one is active. So you wait for the platform to raise up in the background. In case you missed it, there should be like this little platform with a dais right here, like behind La Mesa in this little window. When that starts to raise up, that's when you can teleport out of this room. And not before. If you teleport out before, this next area is not going to work properly. So, the dais raising up is this thing. This is what it activates. So if you don't do that, then you will not be able to put a weight on that, and you will not activate V's boss Ankh. Which is coincidentally what we're going to do right now. So once you've activated this, you want to do 1, 2, 3, 4, or... 1, 2, 3, I think, because this thing will vanish. No, it'll still be 4. Yeah, because there'll be nothing, and then you'll press up, and you'll go to the buckler. So you want to go straight to the chakrams. Interesting. Straight to the chakrams, and then you want your whip for the stuff on the left. And then, yeah, the caltrops are just one off from the chakrams. So you want to turn and throw that. Not like that. I'm going to do this fight properly. I'd rather show and demonstrate how it should look rather than say, oh, I really screwed that fight up, but you know, this is what you're supposed to do. Then you want to come up here, throw the caltrops down, hit them. The only thing during this phase that you really want to watch out for is baiting out that laser. He'll always fire it at the same pace or level, or time, I should say. And then you have to watch out for the fireballs that are falling. Those are kind of RNG.